Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. I study Yixing ceramic since more than 25 years now.
大家下午好，我从事对宜兴紫砂的研究已经有25年的时间。
And today I think it was more exciting to follow a small flower and to try to date it and to see how it was welcome in Europe since the 17th century.
今天的题目就是关于宜兴紫砂陶上的梅花装饰来到欧洲以后，然后对欧洲陶艺家产生的一些影响。
So here on the picture, you can see a resume of what we are talking about. On the top, there is a Yixing prototype, a Yixing teapot with a plum flower applied on the body.
这幅照片上第一幅图上面这个壶上面贴花就是梅花纹贴花。
Just in
Yixing的紫砂壶上梅花纹贴花。
Just below in the middle, you have an imitation produced in Holland by the potter named Harry de Mille.
这挂壶到了欧洲以后呢，欧洲陶艺家就开始模仿。第一个模仿它的就是荷兰的陶艺家，叫阿里德米尔的。
And at the bottom, you have something very unusual. It is a French teapot made of white salt glaze.Influenced also by this kind of decoration of the plum flower.
下面这幅图呢是用法国的一个陶艺家制作的茶壶，它不是红泥的，是一种相当的白泥，但是它里面的装饰纹也是梅花纹。
As regard my challenge, was to be able to date the Yixing teapots. This is my main goal.
那么怎么来对这个梅花纹到底什么时候开始做？大家听。断代，这是一个对他来说也是个挑战。他试图把它描述一下。
And by luck, we have a lot of interesting pieces, interesting teapots preserved in the European Museum that allow us to date quite properly.
很幸运的是，在欧洲很多博物馆里，保存了很多宜兴的紫砂壶，而且这些紫砂壶上都有类似的这种梅花纹贴画。
So this teapot is the first one, the first yardstick that we have in Europe. It is dated of the Ming period. It is housed in V&A Museum.
这把壶在英国的维多利亚阿伯特博物馆里面。那么这一把壶是一个标准器，大家都认为它是明代到欧洲的一把壶。
What is interesting on that teapot, we can be sure it's original and not a copy because you can see the remaining of the antique mounting on the handle, on the spout and the knob also.
这把壶他们认为，大家都认为这是一把真原作，不是后来的，上面它有很多包银的装饰。
And at the base, what is the most interesting is that we have a cyclical date.Corresponding to 1627. So, and if we watch carefully this teapot, you can see that the design is very well done. So, I consider it's not a prototype. It's not the first teapot produced in that way.So, in my opinion, we can date the beginning of that type of decoration of around 1600, something like that.
这把壶是他认为是原作，你要看它的上面的装，就是贴花的装饰啊，装饰非常精致，应该在1600年以前的吧。
And on the seal mark, you can see, of course, that you have the name of the famous Yixing potter we mentioned.
这把壶上面有款，上面写的是惠门城。
So what is interesting is that this plum flower had a strong impact not only in Europe, as we can see later, but also in China. In my opinion, the native city of this kind of decoration was Yixing, but it was also imitated in Dehua and Fujian.
这种梅花纹的装饰不光是出现在宜兴瓷上，在同一个时代也出现在德化的一些瓷器上面。
So here you can see a cup, and just after, probably a wine areas.
这些都是德化的瓷器，酒壶、杯子，上面都装饰有梅花纹。So
now we are going to see different milestones for today, probably this kind of decoration. On this teapot at the bottom here, it was discovered, as you can see, in a Dutch cargo which sank in the West South Africa coast in
1697。这只把壶是从南非靠近南非好望角那边沉船上面挖出来的。这这艘船呢是在1627就沉下去了。那么也就是说，当时宜兴紫砂壶上已经有梅花纹装饰，这是从船上挖出来的。这应该这个是没有什么后期的模仿，这肯定是原作。
So as you can imagine, it was at this moment it was a new stuff. So the cargo sank in 1697. So probably it was made around 1995, something like that.
这艘船是在1697年沉下去。那么这把壶肯定在1697年以前制。So
now I had the luck to study in deeper. The collection of Augustus the Strong. Maybe some of you know already this collection. Augustus the Strong was a king of Poland and great elector of Saxony. He lived at the end of the around the Kanchi period, we can say.
这把壶是德国有一个叫萨克森州的一个玄帝后，他是也是波兰国王，他叫奥古斯都二世，也叫做强人奥古斯都，他收藏这把紫砂壶。
So
他的这个收藏也跟康熙年差不多，他的在位时间跟康熙年代差不多。So
from this spot we can learn some information according to the datation. It was inventoried in 1721，是1721年，大约在1721年收藏，就是这个奥古斯都二世1721年收藏。 Augustus the Strong, we know he bought mainly a new teapot. And this kind of teapot, I think it was produced around 1700.
这把壶大概是生在17世纪，1700年，大概17世纪，16世纪后，17世纪初。
So on the body we can see the appliqué decoration of the plume flower.
上面的那透雕和半透雕装饰，它也是梅花纹。
On the lid, you have a four dog that we found on some Yixing teapot of that period.
这个壶钮是他们叫佛狗，实际上就是狮子，是一个狮子，在欧洲他们可能称之为佛狗。
And also some clouds and some precious
objects. 还有像祥云这样的装饰。So
now we are going to see some teapots from the Augustus Strong collection, which is very interesting in terms of datation.
下面再给大家看几个，就是这个奥古斯都二大力王奥古斯都收藏的一些瓷砂壶。So
on that one, we can see again the plume flower in the reticulating. But what is interesting is that the background is yellow.
这把壶上面也是半透雕，是梅花纹，它的底是黄色，黄底。
That one is more interesting. The background is in a blue color, blue slip, and it is the first time that we have a dated teapot using the blue slip decoration. Because, as you know, it's not a natural color, and the potter, maybe for the first time, had the idea to add oxide cobalt inside the clay.
这把壶的装饰也很特别，它在新的里面装着蓝色的一个底色。 然后再在外面用透用半透雕的形式，也是梅花纹。
So this kind of teapot is typically from the Kanchi period. Reptile with the background with a yellow slip. Here we don't have only a plum flower but also the three friends of the winter, the vine and the bamboo somewhere. This one is very interesting. This is a rare teapot where you can prepare two kinds of tea at the same moment. So in the middle you have a vertical wall, and so the handle can be also a spout or handle, it depends on which side you want to use it. So now this is a piece from my previous collection, which is this collection has been bought in 2010 by a French museum, and it is now in permanent exhibition in the south of France.
这把壶是他的收藏品，但现在都已经在法国普鲁斯边上一个叫巴勒菲，贝勒帕什修道院用这个贝勒帕什的改成的一个博物馆。这个博物馆的名称叫餐饮具艺术博物馆。他现在他所有的收藏都在那个里面展出。So
this teapot is interesting because it is another kind of decoration. Also, the body is molded with the plum flower. The lid has been missing a long time ago, and remake a New European potter rebuilt another one exactly at the right size. You can see the macro of the detail of the molded plum flower decoration. Now let's see another kind. So again, Augustus de Song collection is very interesting because in the past we didn't know how to date this kind of teapot of made of yellow clay. But in the Augustus de Song collection we have several samples inventoried in 1721 in yellow stoneware. So we are sure that it was produced before this period.
这把壶他们当时看的就无法对它断断到底是哪什么时代的，后来在德累斯顿博物馆里面就是这个德国这个萨克森皇奥古斯托尔斯的收藏里有一把类似的一样，他就断定这把壶大概也在1721年左右。
So I suggest the date of datation for that kind of teapot between Kangxi and Yongzheng.
它也是在康熙和雍正之间。
Here also my core of the decoration. It's a slip decoration made by a...
这是一个日会装饰。
Another kind, similar reticulated decoration of plum flower, similar with the teapots that we have seen previously in the Augustus de Song collection.
这把壶跟前面一把壶类似，这是他的收藏。
So here we have a later period of plum flower made in enamel. Here we are in the 19th century. Let's see another sample of 19th century decoration. Applied plum flower decoration. So now we are going to Europe, if you agree. So the first decoration of the plum flower was very fashionable in Europe, and the European potters and the customer was really interested by this kind of design. So naturally, the first potter successful in producing the nearly the same stoneware than the Yixing one was the Dutch potter.
这把壶是荷兰陶器家叫阿里德梅尔的仿制宜兴茶壶，它上面的装饰纹理是梅花。
And as the plum flower was very fashionable, he produced the same type of decoration. I would say that 80 or 90% of the Harry de Mille production is with that kind of design. Let's see the macro now. You can see that the clay wasn't perfect, we had some defective here part. Not the mark, the clay was with not very pure. There is a big difference between Yixing and Holland because in Holland they didn't know to build the teapot by plate. It was turning.
他们做壶是用拉胚组，不是已经这种像打生铜啊、微生铜啊这样。
So here we have the seal.
这是阿里德米尔的土章，它的标志。
It's a fox running.
这是一只狐狸，一只奔跑的狐狸。
So now we are going in England, and nearly the same period, two brothers, their family name was Ehlers, they were native from Holland. But they went to London first, where they produce stoneware like that.
这件作品是英国陶瓷家，有两个陶瓷家，一个是兄弟，他们是用石器，相当于紫砂，也是相当于紫砂，还有模仿就是这个紫砂壶上的梅花五装饰。
That one, of course, is not a teapot. We can consider it. It could be something for the beer or something like that. But the decoration still be the plum flower.
这个当然不是茶壶，它是可能用来喝啤酒的，或者是喝牛奶的。但它的装饰，它是受一些影响，它是文化。So
now about the datation of that one, we are around 1690, 1700.
大概在1697年、1695这个样子。
An English teapot, influenced by the Yixing plum design, but produced later, probably in the middle 18th century.
这把壶大概制作在18世纪中期，是一个英国陶瓷家，但是它上面没有名字，但是很明显，它也是受宜兴紫砂壶的影响。So
now we are going in Germany. This is a teapot produced by Burger. Probably some of you have already heard about him.
这把壶是德国陶瓷家叫波特克，这是一个非常有名的。
Burger was the first potter to be able to discover the European porcelain.
他被认为是欧洲发明瓷器的第一个人。But
what is interesting to know is that before to found the secret of the porcelain clay, he first produced and discovered the red porcelain.
他在发明这个白瓷以前啊，他就首先就研究这个红瓷，他认为宜兴紫砂壶红瓷，所以他开始就仿制宜兴的紫砂壶。那他仿制的版本呢，不是宜兴的壶，他是把阿里的米尔做的这个壶拿过来，然后对付他仿，就是他上面装饰也是梅花。He
has understood that it was the same quality of clay. And from the stoneware, it was easy to make porcelain.
它这把壶已经介于陶跟瓷之间了，相当于石器。So
here about the datation, we are around 1710, something like that.
这把壶大约制作在1710年。
So that is not very famous. This is a French white stoneware. That one is plain, but as we have seen at the beginning, we have some. It's very rare. It was produced at 80 kilometers in the south of Paris, at Montereau, by a French potter named Mazois.
这件作品是法国陶瓷家叫马祖瓦，在蒙特罗。蒙特罗是法国的一个陶都。 他当时这件作品呢，它不是瓷，它是白色的石器，它也是有受宜兴紫砂的装饰的影响。
The knob on the cover is very ergonomic because it's three flowers and it's very easy to take it with the fingers or to remove the cover.
这个胡牛是一个花蕾，那么它很容易拈起来，它不像一个很光，它很容易拿起来。
So here about the meditation, we are in the middle of the 18th century. It is 1750-55, something like that.
这把壶大约在1750年左右，制作年代在1750年左右。
As regard, I like very much the shards. Most of the people think I'm crazy.
这些都是马祖瓦的作品，那些残件在蒙特卢发现的。Okay, because
I think we can learn a lot from the shards. Here it's the shards found in Montero, because we know from the archive that Mazua produced red stoneware also, but we don't have today full pieces, only shards on the right of the image. On the right.
这个马祖瓦呢，大家都知道它做白色的瓷器，但是从质量上看，它也做过红色的瓷器，就相当于紫砂，但是目前现成的 博物馆找到它完整的器型，只能找到一些残件。那么这个就是他在当地发现马祖瓦做的红色瓷器的残件。In
the middle, you have a sample of shards with white sand glazed stoneware with a remaining of birds.
中间这个是白色的瓷器，也是马祖瓦做的。中间这个装饰纹里面有一个图案，是一个鸟。
So now we are later, we are at the end of the 18th century. We have the luck in France to receive an Englishman. He was a politician, he was also a manufacturer of ceramics. He arrived in France at the revolutionary period in 1788.
是一个英国陶器家，但是他后来呢是一个英国的政治家，他后来因为政治上面没有成功，就跑到了法国，就他也是做这个陶瓷，大概在1780年左右到了法国，就从事陶瓷生产，他叫Christopher Porter。
Yes, he had understood that France had a lot of less knowledge in ceramics than in England.
他对陶器的知识，研究对陶器的知识啊，他就是在法国学的。So
he decided to make a research and to improve a different plant for to produce different kinds of ceramic, earthenware, porcelain, and also stoneware. This is
他因为在法国，他在英国他学没有读到这个生产陶瓷的经历，到了法国以后呢，他就开始做一种叫。 陶瓷，然后是金陶，然后有做瓷器。
So he also produces stoneware of different colors. I researched in the archive, so we found exactly the date of arrival of the person who worked for him. He was a specialist in stoneware. He arrived in Chantilly. Chantilly is a nice city near Paris with a beautiful castle. This person arrived in 1796.
他后来又邀请了很多英国的陶器家跑到法国去帮他来制作这些红色的瓷器。And
in the year 2000, I visited the site of Chantilly and I had the luck to find different shards. So that one is a remaining of saucer and a cup stick together with a glass because it produces also glass. So maybe at the same time in the kiln, they produce glass or crystal and stoneware.
这些残器呢，都是他在香榭里，在法国巴黎附近，他发现的一些残器。他发现里面有很多东西粘在一起，而这个粘的都成分是玻璃，因为当时在那个地方既生产陶瓷又生产玻璃器，他们在一个地方。So
when he was ready in terms of quality, you can see he produced nice attempts, something like that. We can have different kind of decoration. Here it is a slip decoration, but we can have also molded decoration. But usually it's not Chinese. That one is a little bit in the Chinese style, but at this moment the European prefers the Greco-Roman style.
这个 porter 他在生产的陶器，那这个时候他的宜兴印象也不是很多了，因为欧洲人慢慢开始倾向罗马帝国的一个时代的那些装饰物。
So this is a sample produced by some friend of him. So when he has the knowledge of how to produce a good stoneware, he gives a secret to some friend. So we have around Paris some manufacturer, Eggball. It's between the end of the 18th century until the Napoleon period.
From 1880s. Yes, at the end of the 18th century. So
here we have a decoration made with a black sleeve, and of course you can see on the lid a swan. But this kind of teapot is very rare. It's very unusual to find that. Maybe it was a small fashion, not a big fashion.
这个这把壶呢，这个形状呢，它受宜兴的启发，但上面的装饰呢，慢慢开始转向欧洲人的风格。那这是一个机会。
Thank you very much for your attention.
谢谢大家。